No, this is not exactly camping season. Nevertheless, it is the first Sunday in Lent. And we are going to go into the wilderness to die as we prepare for Easter Sunday. And as we make our journey through the wilderness, we're going to hear a few stories from the Bible. But first, to get you in the mood, I found a list of camping tips by a man named Bruce Cochran, and this was printed in the 96th issue of Backpacker Magazine. Now, the list was entirely too long to read in its entirety, so I'm only going to mention a few of his tips. When using a public campground, a tuba placed on your picnic table will keep the campsites on either side of you vacant. A hot rock placed in your sleeping bag will keep your feet warm. A hot enchilada works almost as well, but the cheese sticks between your toes. Lint from your navel makes a handy fire starter. Warning, remove lint from navel before lighting the match. Take this simple test to see if you qualify for solo camping. Shine a flashlight into one ear. If the beam shines out the other ear, do not go into the woods alone. The guitar of a noisy teenager at the next campsite makes excellent kindling. Bear bells provide an element of safety for hikers in grizzly country. The tricky part is getting them on the bears. Those are good suggestions for those of you who are planning on camping. Now, I want you to imagine that we're sitting around a campfire on our wilderness journey. Today's journey is with our Master as he is being tempted by Satan. Time in the wilderness seems to be a prerequisite for the promised land of authentic faith. You don't get to the promised land without first going through the wilderness. If you will, notice that immediately after Jesus' baptism, he heard the voice of his Father sigh, "You are my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." And we read these words, "Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He had nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished." Time spent in the wilderness seems to be a prerequisite for a deep experience of faith. God led the Hebrew people out of Egypt, where they had lived in slavery for 400 years. They headed toward the promised land. It was an 11-day journey, but it took them 40 years to get there. What took so long? Now, I know that all of you women out here today, as well as myself, we know the answer to that question. Moses was a man and would not stop and ask directions. Seriously, though, why did God keep them wandering in the wilderness? Even when Joshua took over and led them into Canaan, it was many years before they subdued the land. And even when they were in the promised land and had subdued it, they could not keep it. There came a time when they were carried up into slavery in Babylon, where they cried out, "How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land?" That from Psalm 137:4. Our faith is a wilderness faith. It was born in struggle and hardship. Why was Jesus driven into the wilderness before he began his formal ministry? Probably it was so that he could fully experience what it means to be silver platter. Authentic faith is born in the wilderness of testing and temptation. A writer once told of visiting an orange grove where an irrigation pump had broken down. Because the season was unusually dry, which we know a lot about, some of the trees were beginning to die for lack of water. The man giving the tour then took the rider to his own orchard, where irrigation was used sparingly. He said, "These trees could go without rain for another 2 weeks. You see, when they were young, I frequently kept the water from them. This hardship caused them to send their roots deeper into the soil in search of moisture at a greater depth." Some parents are surprised when they make life as easy as possible for their children and then discover that those children do not respond in the way that the parents had hoped. Here's one of life's most important secrets. There is something about struggle that toughens us and matures us. Time spent in the wilderness seems to be a prerequisite for a deep faith. If life comes too easily, if there are no challenges to overcome, no mountains to be scaled, then we live on the surface of life with no real understanding of God's love or God's sustaining power. This should not surprise us.